Hello again. This is one of the most important things. Again, it's not an original thought of mine. It's an ancient thing. In our tradition, we say Shruti, Mata, Laya, Pita. So Shruti, or being in pitch, is our mother, and Layam, being correct, accurate, rhythmically, that is our father. In our tradition, Carnatic, South Indian classical music, because of various reasons, social, religious, cultural, which I do not wish to go into now, several people succeeded in having successful careers despite not being in Shruti. The problem is that the people who did that, they might have had their own problems for not being in Shruti, and it is full credit to them for having succeeded despite not being in Shruti. But the problem is that people who follow them, they also feel Shruti is optional or doesn't matter at all. Because of which, I'm not saying everybody, there are so many people who sing in Shruti. There are people with really bad voices also who sing in Shruti. That is a different thing. I would definitely prefer to listen to somebody whose voice is not very good but who sings in Shruti than somebody whose voice might be superior but who sing off Shruti. So that is my personal thing. But because of this, what happens is that we get used to that sound of slightly or not so slightly being off Shruti. But any person from any other system of music, starting with Hindustani, so Hindustani singers or playback singers or Western musicians, they find it so ridiculous. See, we can have private conversations between friends where we can speak openly, but I have seen in public forums people from other systems of music actually saying in Carnatic music, Shruti Mata, Laya Pita, and in Carnatic music, the Mata died. So Carnatic music is motherless. I've actually seen people, not once, but more than once. And there's always this kind of insinuation or nasty kind of sniggering when it comes to other musicians or rasikas from other systems talking about Carnatic. Oh yeah, those guys, you know, we know how they are. No, that comes. Again, I don't want to mention names, but there's so much of it online available also. But rather than just get hurt or angry or offended at that, we practitioners of Carnatic musicians, if we take a look, why is it that these people are saying that, then we realize that one, of course, our Gamakam system is so sophisticated that it might be beyond the grasp of some people, and they might find, if you sing only Shuddha Swaram and the Gamakam is not Shuddham, you say the name of one note and you sing something else altogether. That concept itself is alien for many people. But being off Shruti definitely is a very off-putting thing. So, see, there are two approaches to singing, vocalizing Carnatic music normally followed. One is we follow the Veena approach. The other is we follow the Nadaswaram approach. So the Nadaswaram ideally is played in the open courtyard of a big temple without microphone. So you just play and it can be heard and it can impress even if we are standing 500 feet away. So that approach, generally, if we follow in singing also, for the listener, it hits. The impact is very great, the Nadaswaram approach. And over history, we can find so many successful musicians who followed the Nadaswaram style. But Veena style is, of course, we can now with amplification and all that, we can play Veena like Nadaswaram also. That's a different thing. But ideally speaking, or traditionally speaking, how Veena used to be played, there's a much more subtle and perfectly ideal for the kind of Gamakams that we use in South Indian classical music. For example, if I say Panthuvarali, or if we say Varali, this kind of very, very refined ma, which is almost panchamam only. This kind of thing in Veena approach, it'll help a lot. But now coming back to Shruti, so what is Shruti? Shruti is not only being in Shruti, in Sa or Pa, each note has its place. So if you look at Western classical music where they have harmony officially, so at the same time one person will be playing Sa, Sa, another person will be playing Ga, another person will be playing Pa, and Ni, Re, Ma, all together. So together that is harmony. So people who are used to that, they might say, oh, Indian classical music, it is monotonous, just one note. It is not one note, because now when I shut up, you can hear Miss Ragini playing Sa, Pa, Sa, Sa, Sa. So the lower panchamam, two shajams and lower shajam. This is constantly going on. And if I sing a Ni or a Ga, it is not just Ga, it is Ga which is soaked in shajam, lower panchamam and lower shajam. So Ga, I'll raise the Shruti little bit. Ga, Re, Ni, Re, Ma. So Ma, so Sa, Ma, that harmony is there. So it is subtle harmony, not obvious, but it is there. Re, 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 pa, re, 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 pa, ga, ma, sa, re. So this kind of each note having its position. I do these home videos in A Shruti. Sometimes when I teach, because the students might be small children with child voices or female voices, I sometimes teach at G Shruti. For my I generally like lower Shruti, but for my concerts, if it is too low, the strings and the leather of the instruments of my accompanist, it'll be too flaccid and there won't be enough tension. So I sing at B. Otherwise, I would be happy to sing at A also. But the point I want to make is that I sing at G or B or whatever Shruti, but whatever Shruti we sing in, we might not have a big voice range which goes up or down. Range is a different thing altogether. But being in Shruti, any Shruti you sing in, any note, all the time has to be in Shruti. So I'll just give you an example. I'll just take Miss Ragini all the way up to the, this is what, B. So I take B. Ni, ba, ni, sa, ga, sa, ni, sa, ga, ma, pa, ma, ga, ma, ga. Ga, ma, pa, ma, pa, ma, pa, ma, pa, ma, pa, ga, ma, pa, ga, ma, ga, ni, sa, ni, sa, ga, ma, pa, ni, da, pa, ma, pa, ni, sa, ni, da, pa, ma, pa, ni sa ni da pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa da ma pa ga ma pa ga ma ga ri sa si sa. Now I go to A sharp. Sa ni da pa ni sa ga ri sa ni sa ma ga ri sa ni sa pa ma pa ga ma ga ri sa ni sa pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa da ma pa ga ma pa ga ma ga ri sa sa ga ma pa ni sa. This is A sharp. Ni re ni sa ni da pa ma pa sa ni da pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa ma pa da ma pa ga ma pa ga ma ga ri sa sa ga ma pa ma pa ma pa ga ma ga. So whether it's in B, A, or I go even down, ni sa sa ni da pa pa ni sa ga ri sa ni sa ga ma pa ma pa ga ma ga. Pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa sa ni da pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa da ma pa ga ma pa ga ma ga ni sa 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 ga ga ma ma pa pa ma ma pa. This is G sharp. G ni da pa ni sa ni sa ma ga sa pa ma pa ga ma ga ni sa ma ga pa ma ni da pa ma. Pa ni sa ni da pa ma pa ni sa ni da pa ma pa ni da pa ma pa da ma pa ga ma pa ga ma ga ri sa sa. So like this, the Shruti can keep, I'll just go back to A. So any Shruti we sing in, we have to be in Shruti. Whether it is a Shuddha Swaram, suppose we take a, now I sang Behag, which has plain notes, but suppose I take Todi for example. This embracing, hugging sa. That is, we can do that when we are in Shruti. Suppose we are not in Shruti, my sa is kind of sa, little shaky. Then what do you do? Just keep running. So there's one I heard again, one great musician from the past say in Tamil, Yar odrar, who runs? And the answer is, Yarale nikka mudiyadu. The person who cannot stand, who cannot sustain on one note, they are the people who run. This is, it always set me thinking. I know even my own Guruji, Dr. Mangalampalle Balamurukrishna, he was always perfectly in Shruti, but he could really run a lot because, like many others of his generation and later generations, he was influenced greatly by both Nadaswara Vidwan T.N. Rajaratnam Pillai and by G.N. Balasubramanian. There are these two, not these two, there are some musicians whose influence is so great that for several generations it affects and influences people, even people who have not studied with them directly. Yeah, so this is my little thing for today. Be in Shruti all the time, irrespective of what Shruti you sing in.